It's super wide.
We're the super readers.
Let's roll. Spell with me.
Let's give ourselves a big thumbs up.
Super wide, weekdays on PBS Kids. Or watch anytime you want at pbskids.org.
Martha Speaks is funded in part by...
Chick-fil-A proudly supports quality educational programming for the whole family on PBS. The cows have no beef with that.
Fun for everyone makes a family strong. Chuck E. Cheese's proudly supports PBS Kids.
Kitty Academy Child Care Learning Centers, proud supporter of PBS Kids, providing educationally focused child care, preparing children for school and for life. Kitty Academy, community begins here.
The Corporation for Public Broadcasting, a cooperative agreement from the U.S. Department of Education's Ready to Learn grant, the WGBH Children's Educational Media Fund, and by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you! To dig up some more fun words and games, visit pbskids.org or check out your local library for the Martha Speaks books.
Hello, I'm Mike Schneider, here to remind you that NJTV is keeping a very close eye on Hurricane Sandy. Our news crews are covering the Garden State from the north to the south, from the shore to the cities of New Jersey. Special editions of NJ Today at 6 p.m. Monday and Tuesday evenings, and live updates both nights at 11 o'clock. Plus, we'll have extensive coverage of the impact that the hurricane is having on the tri-state area Tuesday night at 9:30, and live streaming on our website 24/7. So stay informed and stay safe.
You're watching NJTV.
Good morning, I'm Rafael Piraman. The New York region is feeling the first rainfall from Superstorm Sandy, now heading straight for the Jersey Shore and predicted to cause massive power outages, flooding, and storm surges that may inundate coastal areas from Connecticut through Long Island and down the coastline of New Jersey. In New York, hundreds of thousands of people have evacuated low-lying areas. The city subways and buses are shut down, leaving almost empty streets to cabs and pedestrians this morning. Government officials and forecasters are warning that the hurricane is life-threatening. The head of the Federal Emergency Management Agency summed it up saying, "Think big." Landfall is now projected for late tonight. NJ Today's Lauren Wanko is close to the eye of the storm's projected path in Cape May, New Jersey. Lauren, what's the latest?
Good morning to you, Rafael. This storm has quickly intensified dramatically since our broadcast to you last evening. It's turning into a beast of a storm. There are monster waves behind me. Now, last night we reported on the number of people who were lured to the beach to watch those waves, number of surfers trying to catch those waves. But right now there isn't a soul out there, and it's pretty easy by the looks of it to understand why. Everything is boarded up here in town. If you drive around, it truly is a ghost town. And it's obvious that residents here have heeded all of the warnings. They're really prepared. And a lot of people I spoke to, a lot of the merchants and the business owners said, listen, We've been in business for 20 years. We've been through so many hurricanes, but we are taking this one very, very seriously. We're staying at Congress Hall, and they have 12 properties throughout Cape May. They boarded up last night over 1,000 windows. And even in our hotel room, they had people come in and board up with plywood the windows from the inside. Everybody is still bracing here for the impact of the storm. And as it intensifies, they know it's coming. The rain is just coming very steadily down hard. It is cold. We are layered with clothes and we're still freezing at this point. And the wind gusts are gaining momentum over 40 miles per hour here. And it's obvious to us now in a short amount of time, we're going to have to be outside and holding on to something hard and steady because we will literally be blown away because of these wind gusts as they continue to pick up. County officials have reported that over 400 people are in shelters throughout the county. Now, that's good news since this is such a dangerous storm, but there are still a few people in town who have not evacuated. A number of those residents actually didn't want to speak to us on camera about it. They just felt like they wanted to stay in the comfort of their home. Again, very unsafe. And in fact, later on today, we will be speaking to the communications director of the Cape May County Office of Emergency Management. Make sure to stay tuned to our broadcast tonight live at 6 o'clock because she will be informing us on everything that people need to do here in the county to stay safe, those in the shelters and those who haven't left their homes. Back to you in the studio, Raphael.
Thank you, Lauren, and please stay safe. Now, preparations have been underway for days, and getting people out of the path of the storm is not easy. We have this report from Long Beach Island from the Star Ledger's videographer, John Munson.
Office of Emergency has issued a mandatory evacuation to be completed by 4 p.m. on October 28, 2012. The Long Beach Island Bridge will close to all traffic at 4 p.m. on October 28th.
And from what I've seen, it doesn't look good. Doesn't look good. Really, you know, the problem is that I see is the moon. You know what I mean? You got normally a high tide around the moon. You can see it hasn't started raining, and there's water around the corner there. There's probably water up the street. It hasn't even really rained at all.
It's all about the tidal surge. That's what's going to really hurt us. It's a tidal surge.
I don't even think the winds are really going to be that big of a factor, except for the 80 mile an hour where the eye hits us. That's going to be a factor, but it's that surge, if that surge is coming directly to the eye, that is. So it's a big one. This is a really, really big one.
Amazing stuff. Now, despite evacuations and preparations, this storm continues to be a life-threatening event. Part of Lower Manhattan and Brooklyn are already underwater at this hour. There are briefings scheduled throughout the day from New York and New Jersey officials, and we'll continue to bring you the latest. Winds are now predicted to gust to 90 miles an hour. Power is already out, shelters are open, and the National Guard is being deployed. I'm Raphael Pierre-Roman. I'll see you throughout the day, and please stay safe wherever you are. We'll see you later.
We now rejoin our regular programming, already in progress.
Understand.